and then living in the atmosphere. We are speaking about World Peace Day. At the end of the day, when you have to just feel today was a peaceful day, things should have happened as per your plan. Then only you will say that it was a peaceful day. And to have a plan, you should have prepared. And to have more number of peaceful days, you should practice that preparation. And today we have seen wonderful speakers. They can be at peace only when they are prepared and the execution has then gone ahead properly. So let me just ask the question to the wonderful speakers today. Deepak, before you delivered your speech, what were the things you prepared for?
Things I prepared was stance, looking at the mirror and trying to speak and seeing any minus negative points or any positive points and push upon them. Practice, and more practice.
Apart from it, those are related to your speech. Apart from your speech, was there anything else you were looking at? That was your objective of the speech, that's what you revolved around. Apart from the speech, do you think, is there anything else you need to be prepared for? Think on. So, Shobhnath, apart from the speech, was there anything you...
Topic,
okay. I'll just come back. Yeah. Apart from the speech, was there anything else you had to prepare for?
The theme of speech and the way of preparation and the way of execution, and I should be bold enough to speak in front of the audience.
Again, that is revolving around the speech. Is there anything apart from the speech you need to prepare?
Yeah.
Anyone else? Yeah.
Grooming.
Yeah. Okay. Anyone else? President?
Being more prepared in the mind.
Okay. Mindful president.
Yeah, apart from the speech, it is the content maybe, of the speech.
Right. It revolves around the speech. Okay. Apart from the speech, do you think anything else we need to prepare?
Expectations from the audience.
Okay. Anil, I see you.
I
go
see.
Ahead.
I have a know that will be in the speech or apart from the speech. If you further explain what we should replace that in, generally, but if you forget, what are the tips that we should have to compensate that mistake?
I see what you're saying. Anything from this side, silent side? Anything else?
Be prepared for the kind of audience that really comes.
Yep.
Like, I think we should be prepared physically also. We should be prepared to come on time and be available ourselves here. And make sure that the president knows that we are giving the speech, and all those preparations should be done. So those are the things we should be keep
true. So when I picked up this topic, I wondered, is there anything else apart from the speech we need to be worried about? And this was an eye-opener for me. That is the question I was just revolving. We'll just take a couple of minutes. I'll just like to play a video which you may have seen, but don't worry if you're not able to hear it because it's just being played from laptop speaker, but just look at the movements of what happens before a president delivers a speech. Bill Clinton, President of America. Okay. We'll just see what are the background activities which just go on. And he's supposed to be one of the world's best orators. Okay. And the world listens to him when he speaks. So, should he be concerned about something or not? What are the things we'll just take a look at? That's him. Hi, tell hi to you. Tell him hi.
Hey.
Don't worry if you're not able to hear. Just, it's okay. This is just 15 minutes before he delivers the speech. Just look at the amount of things which are happening. Anyone has seen this video before?
No.
Okay, I'm blocking pressure. Just keep noticing how many people he has to talk to, and there's a lady who is still coming and decorating his.
Okay. 1, 2, 3. Here I am, gonna Good evening. We're in the Oval Office. I'm a big fan of the...
Happens to all of us. Record a speech, we try to we can become big. Someone updating about the political situation. You have to deliver a speech. See, again, really confused. He's preparing. No, he should not be angry. Okay, again. See, what are the last things you want to do before you deliver a speech? Prepare. And even a president is not a peace. He is the most powerful man in the world at that point. Checking it, where the things are. He's just checking out for the things. Okay. No, that's not me. So this proves it's a prepared speech. Okay. You're looking at the multiple dimensions. Yes, you're concentrating on a speech, and you also should look at how he's going to be looking at. And whether the microphone is working or not.
Ready? Want to try this? My fellow Americans, this evening I want to speak with you about an attack by the government of Iraq against the United States and the actions we have just taken to respond. This past April, the Kuwaiti government uncovered what they...
If the president needs to prepare, we better prepare. A speech is a speech. If it can differentiate to become an outstanding speech, be better prepared. This session was an eye-opener for me, and I wish it same for all of you. We'll just try to see what are the points. So what are the preparations, the practice, which will make us to give an outstanding speech? An example to you. You are mentally prepared to come over here. Suddenly you hear your name wrong. There are things you can get disturbed. That happens to some of us. But how you compose, that was not in your control. But still you compose yourself. That's one small example. Okay? Imagine this, you're speaking over here. Imagine if you're the speaker on that side and the door is over there. You are seriously giving some body action and suddenly someone barges in. How it is going to be handled. Okay? So there are multiple facets involved in a speech, okay? And you need not worry, as soon as you see PPT, you don't remember. It is all available on the Toastmasters website. You can just go around and say with that. Okay? Without any doubt, this is the truth. Once you are prepared, you are at peace. You know what are the things coming. Now what do we, preparing for a speech is essential, that's the main ingredient. There are other things which also matter, like lectern. Let me give you an example. I had been to a club wherein the setup was, it was in a U shape and you had to walk in the middle and talk. You need to a stage movement, the only thing is straight go, come back. No side movement at all because there is a U shaped one. Now, after delivering the speech, I just got to know, invariably the judges sit in the front. And unless you go front, there is no body movement. You need to score points for the body movement. And when you go there, there is all possibility the judges may not hear you. And looking at your back is not a wonderful thing for the judges. Okay? So, when you are going to be delivering at a place, it's better you come a little early so that you know what is the setup. Now, you want to have a printouts or you want to keep a sheet of paper on a lectern which you want to take it up for reference or something. Suppose it's not there, you could have time for them to get it or get it arranged. So there are different things which come in. It depends on your kind of speech, whatever you're going to deliver, whether it's required or not, you come in early and look at it. If you look at the speakers who are coming today, usually our sessions are held on the 9th floor. You are kind of mentally prepared on the room setup. Now suddenly we are on a different floor. The setup may be different. Same thing for you. You have been delivering in a different place. Now this place is different. These are some examples practically. Okay, so that is why this matters a lot. And along with that, I would blend this topic along with what lessons I have learned in the competition. One of the important things in the competition is the timer. Sometimes we don't have the timers, and sometimes we don't know what is the shape and size of the timer card they are using. There has been a competition wherein the timers were using the iPad. You are not able to make out what color it is. And there has been a competition, you believe it or not, three people holding the red color, green color, and there is a time gap. I don't know what was the logic behind it. They wanted to show off their iPad or what. But that can be surprises. We are used to one color, but we don't know. And another surprise is, sometimes the timer may be 5th minute and a yellow card was shown. And that person got shaken up. Okay? And this has been a practical thing in a humorous speech contest. One of the best amazing speeches. It was too good. He was a sure to be the district champion. And he went overtime. The timer was flashing the card. Everything was being done. He was blind. Now, we may think, why didn't they have a sound or anything? It's our responsibility to tell to the contest chair, get to know the things. These are not in our control, but this we need to do. Today we are delivering speeches at the club level, but our aim is to go to the international level. We all wish to become very good speakers. These are the kind of things which we need to be concerned about too. So lectern and audience, that's where it comes into. Microphone usage. You saw the president of America worrying whether the microphone is working. After he delivers half the speech, he shouldn't be told that you are on mute, nobody is able to hear. That's a horrible thing. We look into detail. These are the main things which we'll be looking at. Room conditions, obviously. Jay spotted out like the room was dark. Actually, I was prepared for my speech, that's why I kept it ready. I thought the lights would be on. That's just an example, how you want. Okay. Visual aids. Obviously, we'll look into the details. This is straightforward. Now I just keep putting this and I walk here. Obviously, it's going to be irritating, right? Now we look at each one in detail. Lectern and audience. The example what I give, it depends on the kind of setup it is so that what you are comfortable. Suppose your speech is something you are going to be walking around. So if you come early only, you will get to know whether there is place for you to walk around or not. Okay? So you have to be comfortable with the speaking area. Next is audience. Obviously, if you want to reach out to the audience, you want to talk, obviously you need to know the place where they are. There was a speech, in a speech contest, one of the speaker, towards the fag end of his speech, it was a humorous speech, he wanted to end by proposing to a girl. Obviously the setup was done, the fixing was done, and the place was fixed. And unfortunately, that girl came a bit late. And he had practiced very much going there and all, he was ready. Because before the speech, I saw him counting the number of steps it takes to go to that place, he was just doing it. Then suddenly, we know it, usually nobody walks in between a speech. Suddenly I saw a girl coming, she's asking someone to get up and all, and it was looking rude. Then only we got to know what is it. Now, if you're a person who is counted, like they're going to be sitting on the first seat or second seat. Now imagine you're going to be on a stage and which has got steps. You have to count for that time. So it depends. You have to customize your speech accordingly. Okay. If I'm at plain surface, I can walk. Now, whether these matter, yes, it matters. Those few precious seconds in your timing when you deliver a speech. Right? How many of you feel these are eye-openers? These are small things which we tend to overlook. Microphones. There was an evaluation contest being held at Royal Orchid Hotel, and it was a huge auditorium. I think that was the time when you delivered your speech also, Sagliano speech, I guess. And for some reason, I was shy at using a microphone. I didn't know how it will sound or anything. And unfortunately, I was the first evaluator. So I didn't have the mindset to go and find out how the microphone will work. I thought like my voice is loud, I can shout and all. Then hardly the voice reached the people. Okay. The yardstick is, if there is a microphone, use it. If there is a problem with microphone, leave it there. How will you get to know? Only if you go and check it out. microphone can decide between a victory and losing also. Okay. Shalaja, would you like to share what happened in your microphone? You see, we have got a person who was at the finals and what unfortunate event happened. She can share.
District finals, Euro speech contest, we had been to Kochi and it went very well. I checked my mic also. But what happened after checking, I didn't realize that I was wearing a chain and had fixed the mic and checked it, but I didn't realize that when my movements might move the chain also. And at that time, on the stage, while I was speaking, nothing could be heard properly because each time I moved, the chain went grrr, grrr, along with the mic. So that is how I lost the finals, I can say.
So how many want to lose that? And it was a sure shot winner speech, as per me. I haven't seen other thing. And she had used the microphone in the previous level also. So sometimes things are not in our control. Okay. So that is why it's very important. Microphone, a small thing, it can determine between a victory and a loss. And another point is sometimes the microphone falls off. Okay. So you just check it out with the contest chair. Ideal, last time I heard that there are 30 seconds grace period. So the catch is the timer should know and the contest chair should know, chief judge should know. So whenever you are in the contest next time, check it out what to do if the microphone falls. Okay. There has been a case wherein the microphone fell down and this person started shouting. The judges felt sympathetic towards it and he won. That's another story. He or she, I don't know. But that is one more thing, but don't write down. Okay. That may not work every time. So, a microphone can play havoc, okay? A tiny instrument, okay? My suggestion is come early, go to that person who is in charge of it. And another thing is with microphone is the way you're going to wear it matters. Within your hands, the wire hangs around. I don't know, how you manage it, it's left to you. My point is like whatever you're comfortable with it, do it. When to use a microphone? When the audience is more than 100, you want everyone to listen to it. Most of the time we assume that judges are in the front row. It doesn't matter if I shout, if the judges listen, that is sufficient. That's the point of audience participation which comes in. If the audience doesn't understand what you're talking, judges are going to mark down. Okay? So this is very much thing, and this is straightforward. If the audience is above age of 50, don't take chance. Be loud and clear, okay? Obviously, poor acoustics, and if you have a voice problem, voice strain. Now, why I say again, coming to the point, check it out with your microphone, because sometimes our voice are loud, we are used to it. Because we had one of our club member who delivered a speech which was very loud for that too. We went and told you are very loud, very loud. He was confident, and when we went, the next level was in IMV. And he went to that auditorium, he toned down his voice because people told it's very loud. And then it hardly reached the people because there was no microphone. That's another story. But you need to adjust as per the room. Okay? Room conditions. Now, what is the big deal with it? A room condition. You don't know the speaking area. Sometimes it might be too cold. You don't know it. Okay? It's better to check the temperature. Because I have seen one contestant coming on the stage and what I wanna say, like that, the voice was shivering actually. He had prepared well, but it was not in his control. Over a period of time, first of all, when you come to the stage and in the contest, you have butterflies along with the cold things. So there are too much things. So one of the suggestion for this is like, you can have a blazing that at least will protect you from the cold. And if it's really cold, someone will be there wearing a blazer, put it. It's better if it's even if it's ill-fitting, it's fine. At least you be comfortable with your speech. Okay. So definitely it makes point to check out the room temperature, appropriate lighting, obviously. So I had set it up for my usage and Jay spotted it for different things. Okay. This is the point I was just coming to. Late comers. Sometimes you don't know. Your speech may get distracted by many things. Once we were in the ninth floor and the speaker was fully involved in the speech and non-Toastmasters. They just came, they told, hey, you flick the chairs from the other room, return it back. But they just came, they had a meeting. And obviously work is important, we have to do it. Okay. This may not happen in community clubs, but in corporate it happens. Okay. So this rule holds good for a club speech or a contest speech anyway. Competitive noise outside. I had been to a community club in Alanka, and they hold their club meetings in a school. It's a school and they just hold it over there. In that, there are late evening classes happening for the other sections, and the students repeat. Now you have to hear that sound. And the school is right next to the main road. You hear the bus sound. Now, those are things which are not in your control. Now you have to drown those voices, you have to shout. If you shout, you lose your control. There are sometimes you can probably you just close the window or try to see what is the best you can do. Okay. And in the same club, I just noticed one very interesting thing. Last Saturday, they had their humorous speech and evaluation contest. And the contest started at 7 p.m. The evaluation contest went fine. Humorous speech started, power cut. We are at the luxury. We are in a corporate place and some companies, we have the backup power supply, but that need not be the case everywhere. Now all the participants were okay with delivering the speech in darkness. That was only the torchlight from the mobile, that was sufficient. Now if you are using a prop or you are going to show some written display in your part of your speech, it goes for the toss. You don't have an further, I'm not asking you to carry your emergency light or anything of that stuff. But there can be surprises. We have to just go with the flow. We just see how we can modify it. Like today, during the speech, she did a wonderful thing wherein from a prepared speech, she told like what Prashant said, I am a perfectionist. You're going away from the script. You're just molding yourself. Same thing happens when you're trying to use the word of the day. Same way over here, like what Anil said, in what we forget instead of that what when we are interrupted also being prepared for it. Okay. Any questions still here or no? Just go ahead. Jay, you want to add anything? Visual aids, straightforward, all of us love to use it. You mentioned about your daughter. Don't you think she's more intelligent? This generation kids, I know you won't accept it, but how many of you feel these generation kids are more intelligent and they have more knowledge, right? So that's the way it is becoming. And if you look at it, the project ones are becoming innovative. There was a time only in project 8 we used to use visual aids. Now project 1 only people are jumping in. And it's more essential, we just try to see how we handle it. So straightforward visual aids. Obviously, straightforward, where everyone can see, okay? Not like I was blocking Prashant's view. Okay. Straightforward. Now, what if the projector doesn't work? That's possible. You can't run in between or anything. So it's better to have the printouts ready. Okay. So these are all the recommendations which Toastmaster gives. Okay. So all this PPT is available. These are very valuable suggestions. This is subtle, but these are all very valuable suggestions. You just have your PPT and the show goes on. What all can happen wrong? May happen, but you can keep it ready. At least you know where it is. At least you can just keep glancing at it. I know what the evaluator may say, you should not have used notes. That's all would have been told, right? But at least your show goes on. Now coming to this, everyone agrees to it. Rehearsing the speech is very essential. Practice ideas, not words. Once you know the flow, automatically you can just put in the words and take it forward. And if you want to link up with something in between, like the third place winner, Pramod, right? Was that
international?
Singapore guy?
Manoj Vasudevan.
Manoj Vasudevan. He used the girlfriend name of Aditya in his speech. So you can be innovative, like what she used, Prashant example. So you can go ahead with it only if you are flexible with it. Okay. This is what the point Andrea mentioned. You just have the mental draft of your speech. That is sufficient. Then we can just play around. The problem with mugging up is what we face in the school days. We forget the one, that's it, we forget it. need to start from the beginning. This is a very important point. This was an eye-opener for me. What happens, usually we tend to practice a speech, we are stuck, we stop there, we try to go from the beginning. Toastmaster recommends, you go ahead, you just make a note of it, okay, I was stuck up over here, or I'm just not remembering. With this, we become more familiarized with the flow. Okay, so this will definitely help when you deliver a speech, you know where is the place where I need to concentrate more, or where is I need to give more punch, or where I need to yawn more. So that also can be thought of. At this place, I would like to borrow one of the sentences which Prashant wrote. Hey buddy, I'm not that boring, okay? I remember that. Okay, and these are, once you start improvement areas gradually, okay? And forward, you have someone for the feedback. And everyone likes extra things, okay? Provide an introduction, okay? Heard of the Better Speaker series before you came to the today's session. The hands are in minority, okay? So this, I had to send him an email so that he just reads it out. Same way, your speech, you can send a couple of lines, like what you said for the joint family and SMS. Like that, it's better you just send out a couple of introductory lines. I'm going to deliver this speech and what it is about. So that will also add value to it. Okay, so I need not spend time on what is a Better Speaker series because he had already spoken about it and I save my time over there. Okay, and prepare yourself physically. This is very important because sometimes I have seen some people becoming hungry just before a contest, okay, or becoming thirsty. I'll just take a couple of minutes. in last time contest, I don't want to name the venue. I was just entering into the contest and I was the next speaker and I couldn't find a glass of water. I just watered a glass of water and I couldn't find it. So it is better we prepare ourselves. You just carry a bottle of water or something because those can affect your flow. You feel, okay, I've not taken, my throat may be like this, like that. So let that not be the things which affect your flow. So here what they recommend is like physically, there is one speaker, Vishal Sarkar, what he had suggested is before you give your speech or talk to yourself more like just so that your voice just gets used to it before you speak. So there are tons of things available. And mental rehearsal, you can have it like, okay, the Toastmaster is going to call me. There's an applause, I come onto the stage, I deliver it, then there's an applause. You can just have a mental preparation, so this will make it much more easier. How many of you agree with this line? Concluding, when the president prepares, let us better prepare.